Whispering Tactician back with another video. Now before we move on, please like the video as it helps the channel very much. Comment down below and subscribe to the channel. More similar content is on its way. So we are reviewing the games from Tuesday. Some very interesting games, of course the last of these groups. And of course we had Czech Republic against England in the 8 o'clock kickoff, as well as Croatia, and England won their game, meaning that they finished top of their group. And I will be doing a tactical analysis on this game because there was a lot to break down, a lot to talk about, so that will be up maybe tomorrow or the day afterwards, because of course France are playing, so I might upload it on the Thursday, just so we can have a bit of time to break it down. But England were very good in this game in the first half. I think I know exactly why they were very good, but I will break that down of course on Thursday on another video. Czech Republic were okay, I think they were just very average. I expected a bit better from them, but I did expect, you know, them to give England a better game, but England were very comfortable throughout the game. They didn't really have a lot of chances against them. If we go through some of the stats as well, you know, England had 5 attempts and Czech Republic had 7. Like, it doesn't really tell it does tell the story that England can't create a lot of chances, but of course England had a lot of possession, dominated the game, but didn't really do much with the ball in the second half. They kind of just saw the game out, and you know, England went away with the 1-0 win. Their passing accuracy was also 85%, so it was quite high compared to Czech Republic. But in games going forward, of course that will need to improve. Of course, in the other 8 o'clock kickoff, Croatia beat Scotland, meaning Croatia finished second, and they beat them by a score of 3-1, meaning they go above Czech Republic. I did flick to this game occasionally, but I didn't watch it in its entirety, so I wouldn't know exactly what happened. However, from, you know, what I did watch, Croatia seemed to be in control. Of course, you can see there's 64% possession for Croatia. Scotland, I did also flick back to their channel when the goal went in, because it created a very interesting twist that even Scotland could have gone through at that point, but it seems like they didn't. And Croatia just dominated the game and eventually saw the game out. And credit to Croatia. Obviously, well done to Scotland for getting a point at least in the tournament. This is their first major tournament since 98, so it's great for them to get a point as well against England. And if we have a look at the table, England finished first on 7 points, Croatia second on 4 points, Czech third, and they're through on 4 points, and Scotland in 4th place on 1 point. It's going to be interesting who England do get in their game. Moving on to the fixtures tomorrow, reviewing the fixtures for the Wednesday games. On Wednesday we have a game at 5 o'clock. Sweden versus Poland. This is probably a low-key, very interesting game. It's going to be very tactical. Just I say that because Sweden have defended very well throughout this tournament, and they got a goal against their opponents last time. However, it's going to be interesting to see how they fare against Poland. I'm going for a draw in that game. Slovakia versus Spain. I think Spain might finally get their first win, but again, they have to be very careful because Slovakia only need a point to go through. feel like Spain, of course they're at home. I think they'll get the job done and they will go through. I'm saying a 2-0 win for Spain in this game. Of course, they'll probably dominate a lot of possession as well, which is typical of Spain. Looking at the group, Poland on 1 point, they definitely need to win. Spain need to win. Slovakia don't need to lose. And Sweden are essentially through. But I'm pretty sure they just want to draw the game and not lose. And they'll go through first. So it's going to be interesting. An hour and a half or so in this group. And then we have the big guys in Group F, right? So we have Germany playing Hungary. Now, I underestimated Hungary. I knew they were a decent side, but they got a draw against France. It doesn't mean they're the best side in the world, but it means that they can frustrate their opponents. I've seen it in the way they play. I think Germany will win though. I'm going for a 2-0 win. And then the biggest game probably of the match day 3 between Portugal and France. This group can go anyway. You know, Portugal win, Germany win, France finish in third, and they probably go through still, but it just means that they're not actually through in the first, in the automatic places in first and second. So it's going to be interesting for them to see if they can overcome Portugal. I am going for a 2-1 win for France. I think Portugal might miss out, but they'll probably give it a go. They'll probably score a goal. Maybe it might be 1-0 at one point, and you know, France need a goal, Portugal need a goal, and we'll probably find that France maybe nick a win. Anyway, those are my predictions for this game. Please let me know what your predictions are for this game as well. I'm very intrigued to find out what you guys think. And as always, thank you very much for watching. Please hit the like button, subscribe as well. And I will catch you on the next video. Thank you very much.